Hi, everybody. I'm Sean Gossett, and welcome to Season 1, Race 2 of my NASCAR Heat Evolution career. We are going to Atlanta Motor Speedway for the start of really the season proper. You know, Daytona is the great equalizer because it's a plate race, and we did pretty well. But now we're going to come out here to a track that's really going to show us, you know, how the season is going to go. This is really going to set the tone for the rest of the season. So here we go. Into career mode. Yes, we are resuming. I'm not really sure what to expect out of this one. I've run some practice laps here. And, you know, we did okay. But I'm curious to see how this car is going to do. But this is a track that really suits me. I pride myself on my 1.5 mile quad oval driving. That, to me, that's kind of my bread and butter. So we'll see. But let's get right into it. Remember, kids, safety first. I'm still trying to get the mics dialed in. So, you know, we'll see how this goes. But we're here at the track. I'm going to run a few practice laps, shake down how the car's doing, and we'll see you at the end of qualifying. Okay, well, we were 25th fastest in the first round, and I think we just missed the cutoff to round two. Yep. All right, so 25th fastest. We were able to... The car's fine, because I was able to ride flat out the entire lap. It just means we're slow. So, yeah, that's 25th is a pretty good starting position. I'm pretty happy with that for the kind of car we got. So let's go to the race, see how that goes. My lane did not get a good start. Three wide already. Ooh! Come on, McDowell, I was down there.
Still there.
No more yellow line rule. So we can dip below if we want to. I was able to take qualifying laps flat, but in traffic, I'm a little more timid. It's only lap two. I don't want to wreck it. I'm gonna shut up while we're in traffic. I need to concentrate.
Still there? Still there? All clear.
All clear. Here's a question, low or high? That was 32. Competitive lap time around here is in, what, the low 30s? Alright. We're by ourselves a little bit. Now I can start talking about Atlanta. Get us some content. I really like this track. This is a fun track. I know everybody loves to hate on the 1.5 mile cookie cutter quad ovals, but man, are they fun to drive. Now I'm in a slow car, which means I can just go flat the entire time, but when I was doing my playtesting in the top equipment, I could still drive way deep into the turns before I had to lift, and that was a lot of fun. Plus, this place is so tough on tires, so that always makes for good racing. Everybody's bummed that they're repaving it after this race. But, I mean, you know, necessary evil. It happens. You just hope that it weathers itself. Ooh, we got tight there.
Still there?
I'm interested to see how I'm going to handle tire fall off here. I have it set to normal, so, and what, this race is about 40-something laps, so we might be sliding around by the end. I think we're good on fuel.
Still there? Still there?
Oh, boy. I could have gotten aggressive there, but it's early. Can't win the race on lap 8, but you can sure as heck lose it.
Still there? Still there?
I'm gonna get on the bottom. I don't think I'm getting anywhere up top. Alright, let's see what we can do with McMurray. We're single file now. We can get a run off this corner. Nope. He blocked low, and that made me really get a poor entry. Passing is becoming more difficult. Looks like we got about a 16th, 17th place car. Which, hey, you know, second race, new equipment. Oh, there's a wobble from McMurray. And we are there to pounce.
Still there?
Oh, fighting back hard on the outside. He cleared us. Wow. We're in his bumper a little bit.
Still there?
He's probably not too happy with us for that. Alright, looks like this is where the fight's gonna be, right, for 17th. Whoa! Ah, I slid the tires there. I think he's gonna get a better run coming out of the turner. Here comes Paul. Paul on the bottom. Ooh, we got into him. Sorry. Bobby, tell the 27 spotter I didn't mean to get into him there. That's my fault. Bad turn. I feel like I'm faster than these guys, but they're just playing defense really well. They're taking away my line, and I'm not faster than them out of my line. Alright, let's see what we can do here. We're gonna go high and try and get a run out of the turn. Oh, so did he. Maybe I shouldn't have said that. Maybe he heard me. Alright, here we go. Crossover. No, we don't have the run. Alright, well, a trio of Chevys fighting it out for 17th. thing is, whenever we get a run, we're too far away to make the pass before the corner. And they're there to block it, which, you know, I'm not mad at him. NASCAR, you block. That's what you do. Oh, see, that's what happens. He's always in my line. Give him a shove down the straightaway here. Maybe try and make him go into the turn faster than he wants to. Here we go. Uh-oh. We got more company. It's the 34 of Landon Castle. That man always finishes better than he qualifies. He's better than his equipment. Four-way fight for 17th now. We're sliding. We got real tight. I might have to try a bump and run. I'm getting nowhere on the outside, and they are blocking on the inside really well. And here comes Stenhouse. Alright, I'm going to start getting a little defensive. Dadgum. I think I'm abusing my tires. Which is neat, but not good. Maybe we gotta start running the middle.
Still there?
Had to get out of the gas that killed our run coming out of the turn. We would have washed up into him though. That right front's down to 80. 80%. I think tire wear really is going to be an issue here. Oh, he got into us. If a caution comes out, oh boy, I'm going to have a tough decision. Because I don't know if anybody else is going to pit. Everybody can make it on fuel. We've got a decent spot right now. If nobody goes with us, we will lose so much track position. Well, I hope it's not boring for you guys that I'm not getting anywhere. Because I'm actually having a blast fighting for my life for 19th. Here we go. We got some lap traffic. Or maybe not lap traffic, but traffic. We might be able to steal a few. For Bobby. Car's fine. Whoa. Yep, that's a lap car. Dang it, now he's really slowing us down. And here comes Stenhouse. Oh, things are about to get tight. There we go, using that car as a pick. You stole us one. Let's try to be nice to the tires. I think Menard's just a little bit faster than us. There's a lap car. He's slowing up McMurray. Alright, Bubba, which way are you going? I bet he's going low. He got loose and that killed us.
Still there?
And here comes Menard. Okay. He slowed up Menard too, though. That was good.
All clear.
Well, things go our way. We might be able to steal 17th with the slap traffic. But this is about what we got. We got an 18th place car. Which again, for brand new team, bottom tier equipment, not bad for race two. There's Joey Gase. I am just as fast as Joey Gase in real life. In the fall race at Texas Motor Speedway, I guess I should say last year by now, they had a promotion. You could win a PlayStation 4 if you set the fastest overall time at Texas Motor Speedway on this game. I don't know what wheel they used, but Joey Gase, the very real NASCAR driver Joey Gase, he set the bar with the first run, and later he would come back and set one that was higher, but I beat Joey Gase's first time, just barely. So now every single time I hear Joey Gase's name, I have to remind everybody in the room that I am as fast as Joey Gase. Oh, come on. Pick a lane, lap traffic.
Still there.
And here comes Stenhouse.
Car high.
What are you doing, Ryan Reed? Stenhouse is still there.
Yep,
he's still there. I knew it. Starting to get into, crunch time. Oh, we washed way up into him. That was my fault.
Still there?
Hopefully he just knows that's just racing. Well, that was my fault entirely. Good news is, looks like there's not many people out back. Yeah, tire wear is definitely becoming an issue. Ooh, down to 67%. Yeah, that right front's really having a hard time gripping coming out of the turn. Is that Suarez? Man, these game developers do not have much faith in Suarez. Of course, I'm a little biased. I really like Daniel Suarez. He's got a great attitude.
Stay on. Still there. All clear.
I mean, y'all know I was a Jeff Gordon fan.
10 laps to go.
And I'd say Suarez, you know, nobody can ever replace Gordon, but Suarez might be my guy for the next few years. I really like him. Oh, here comes Chase Elliott. Is he the leader? He's the leader! Uh-oh. Chase, are you gonna do it? First career win at his home track. Wouldn't that be a story? Far from over yet. Well, a little disappointed that we went a lap down, but that's all right. We're running 18th. That's not bad. Wow, Chase has a huge lead. Chase has led a lot of laps and not won before, though, so it ain't over yet. Man, those Hendrick cars looking strong, though, at the start of the season. Junebug won the 500. Our 500. I'm talking about fictional me NASCAR. Yeah, he slowed us up. And now Chase Elliott's leading at Atlanta. Uh-oh, here comes Paul Menard. Ty Dillon really slowed us up. Oh, that killed our lap time. Oh, and there goes Junebug in second. Wow. And Jimmy in third. Hendrick Motorsports just dominating here. Good Lord. Putting a beatdown on the field. When was the last time we had a 1-2-3 finish from a team? Have there been any since 1997? Seems as good a time as any to segue into the 97 500. That is the race where I became a NASCAR fan. I was like 4.5 years old, and I liked playing with Hot Wheels more than any other toy. And so my dad brought home a hero card. Like, he got it for free somewhere, probably just went and got an oil change, and they were giving him out. But it was a hero card depicting that Hendrick Motorsports 1-2-3 finish. And I was like, oh, that's just the coolest thing ever. So from that day forward, diehard NASCAR fan, diehard Jeff Gordon and Hendrick Motorsports fan. So yeah, I am a little biased, but wow. Another Hendrick 1-2-3. That's amazing. Here comes Kyle Busch in, fourth? We'll give him room.
Still there?
Go get him, Kyle. DiBurrito slowed him up. Come on, DiBurrito. I'm gonna go high. Give him room. Uh-oh, this isn't looking good. I'm gonna let him go. They're racing for the win. Oh, Kyle Busch has to be livid with Matt DiBurrito right now.
Still there?
I'd be.
Here you go.
All right, two to go. 57% on the right front. I mean, it's definitely worn, but we'll be all right. Is that in the rear view? Is that DiBurrito? Okay, we got a 2-second gap to Menard. Oh yeah, and that is the last lap because we're a lap down. Oh, and I completely screwed up the corner entry looking at the stats. Sorry, we got a 2-second gap. I think we'll be all right. I wonder who won. All right, boys, 18th. Yeah. Way to go, guys. Not bad. I'm proud of us. Thanks for putting together a good car. We'll take that 18th. That's pretty good. That is pretty good. All right, so 18th. Overall, a pretty solid day for us. You know, I'm disappointed that we didn't finish on the lead lap, but I can't complain too much. The 18th is a good day. And he did it, you guys. Chase Elliott, first career win, and it comes in a Hendrick Motorsports 1-2-3. Wow. Wow. That is just a beatdown on the rest of the field. That's crazy. All right, well, let's see where the points stack up. There's a 19th place at Daytona and an 18th place here, so we should be somewhere close to that, I'm assuming. All right, pretty good winnings. Let's see where we are. We got 45 points, and yep, right there. 18th place in points. You know, two races in, not bad. Not bad. We got Trevor Bayne and Kurt Busch ahead of us, and AJ Allmendinger and Landon Cassel right behind. So let's head back to the team shop and do some housekeeping, and we'll wrap this one up. All right, and everybody waiting for race two of the Goodyear Cup Series, the stop motion series. I've got like two laps to go on filming. Once I'm done filming, I'll release the... Ooh, Ryan Blaney was on the move. He started... Wow. Good for Blaney. Anyway, once I've finished filming, I'll release the qualifying video I made for that, and I can get started editing that. So let's head back to the shop. And Las Vegas is next week. Hey, we picked up some secondary sponsors. All right. Nice work, Dave. Check them out and make adjustments in the sponsor menu. All right, well, this is new. Check this out. You can earn extra cash during a race by displaying secondary sponsors on your car and completing their requirements. Here at the sponsor page, you can adjust which secondary sponsor you want to display on your car. Some sponsors are willing to pay more, but expect more for it. As you progress, you'll have more locations to display these sponsors. Some locations are more valued than others, so choose wisely where you want to put a sponsor. I added a few words there. Hold on. Okay. So, looks like this is what we got. Okay, we've only got one slot, it looks like. And K-Love is offering a little more than 5,000 to lead a lap. We're nowhere near that yet. Qualified 20th, we qualified 25th at that last race. But, you know, I want to go for the sure thing, or at least the mostly sure thing. We've finished 18th and 19th in our past two races out. And MDS, I don't know what they do. Looks like they've got the shape of Tennessee in their logo. So if anybody knows what MDS is, leave a comment. Let me know. I'm too lazy to go Google that. But I think we are going to go with MDS. They want a top 20 finish out of us. I think I can deliver that, and it's almost $1,000 more than the next one, which is 25. So let's go for MDS. Welcome aboard, whoever you are. All right, so let's go to the team, see what kind of money we got. We got 12,000. Not near enough to buy anything. 20,000 is going to be what we need to get something. In my last race, I said I was going to try and prioritize grip, but since we were able to run the entirety of Atlanta flat out, you know, with the exception of traffic, I'm thinking we might need some more power, so it might benefit us to just go for the cheapest one, which is a 1% horsepower improvement. Bigger than 0%, I guess. And then, can we even look at that? Okay, no, can't even look at the next thing. But, yeah, I guess that'll be what we're looking at. Unless, by the time we were able to afford anything, it's short track time, in which case I'd want grip. Okay, well, can't buy anything yet. And I think that is going to do it for race 2. 18th, solid day. Pretty happy with that. Thanks for watching. Leave a comment, and I'll see you guys in Vegas.